75 once?
75.
By the way, just because your gesture is so wonderful, what's your name?
Sharon Bentley.
Sharon. Oh, of course. Sharon, I have something that you would not be the only other person who has. I have a piece of videotape at home. Nobody's ever seen it ever.
Oh, yeah?
It was, we were hanging out at the craft service table one night. Uh-oh. This was one, uh-oh, when, the, what was the name of the episode that Ron directed? Time for Midnight. Okay. Well, during the process of making that episode, Patty, the craft service woman, had wandered around the stage with her video camera and just sort of got, it was like the first time we ever just kind of had the wherewithal to do that, which unfortunately, and she videotaped just everybody doing what they were doing. Mostly it was a gift for Ron, so that Ron has sort of like a very unique visual memento of his experience as a director. But backstage by the craft service table one night, it was late, it was raining, we were in this theater. And Joe Anderson does, on videotape, and I will send you a copy, I'll make a dub of it, send to you, I'm a Little Teacup. And that's all I give to you, Sharon. So make sure you write the book of this. Wouldn't it be nice if that's all? I'm sorry. Now, it's actually very funny. She came back later and did the Pop-Tart song. But that's going to have to be reserved for another gift that's appropriate to that. Thank you, Sharon.
Our next item, it comes in a cardboard tube, all its own. Yeah, we have a lovely item. Oh, it's a very famous picture. This is a large blow-up.
This is it. This adorns the wall of my house, a smaller version of it.
This is the cast.
Where are you?
I'm not here. Sharon forgot to invite me.
See, Dave had some busy days at the set.
Yeah.
This is the chamber of the chamber of the winds.
This is the Great Hall. This is the back of the Great Hall, right?
Yeah. The back of the Great Hall. This was the cast photograph. Someone got a copy of it and made a negative of the original, but. Here's the really important people.
You have Victor Lovell, you have Mr. Lovely.
Here's me up here, and here's Ron and Linda. There's Eric! George R.R.
David.
Here's all the team members over here, I'm sorry.
We're reminiscing over here. Oh,
look. You need to mention to them, because they cannot see it, that Ron is in his Vince makeup in Hawaii.
Oh, yeah, but by the way, it's not true.
Yeah,
thank you, Carolyn. We used to have theme days on Beauty and the Beast sets. There was Cholo Wednesday, where everyone had to come up with their favorite South Central Cholo brother. And then there was All Black Day, where everybody had to come dressed in black. That day was the Die in Hawaiian Day. So a lot of people that worked for the set, including Ron, have Hawaiian shirts on. And that was sort of like, that's what I did for a living. I chose theme day. And today is Red Licorice Day. You have to walk around with red licorice out of your mouth. That happened to be the Die in Hawaiian Day, and they came out and took pictures. So that's the sort of Don Ho theme of the day. And Ron actually stayed in costume for the will I sign it? Yeah, I'll sign it, absolutely. If anyone wants to revise it, I'll sign it, sure.
David,
darling?
Someone asked if you're taking the book already to Ron,
do you want to come up here and do this? Like, okay, that's until page 7 of the, okay, well, here's the deal. I get as many signatures as I can on that, we'll start the bidding at $100. And you're just going to have to trust that I'll do my best to get more signatures than have ever been available. $100, thank you, then. $300 for Beverly. $300, $300 is where we are in autograph, blown-up group picture of the Beauty and the Beast cast and crew, signed by everyone I even see between now and when I know it, I don't remember rising. $300 is the bidding. Do I hear $325. Do I hear the next bid, which is 3:33. I like that. 3:33 for all you neurology freaks. 3:33. David! 3:30 is the bid. You
order it?
3:30. Okay, 3:30 is the bid. It's actually the only one of that size. It's all the ones we have. The photograph we got is just like an 8x10.
Vincent should have surfed in an episode. Yeah. This really looks good in beach club.
Yes.
You gotta show him.
Well, here's the thing about that. I don't know who made that. I would do that with mine. I don't know that I would want to blow it up that big because I think I think if we're going to do that, it would be cheaper to do 8x10. But I don't know that I can do that without like at least asking one or two people if they're okay with that. Because it's also, I got to be honest with you, it's a real unique thing. I mean, that was like the one time in the universe. I mean, there are people on there that never met prior to the taking that photograph. The seamstresses, people from the editing room that had never been to the set. There are a lot of things that happened that unique experience. Because we all afterwards had a barbecue on the set. After we finished the work, and there's a lot that's tied into that photo that's not just like a cast photo, because we were so far away from the rest of the world. We were, you know, most of you know, we filmed the show so far away from where the editors were, and like the costumers, and the music people. So that was the one day where people were like, oh yeah, I see your name on the credits. There's a lot that's tied into that, it's really personal, so that's, you know, that's probably why this photograph hasn't been made available before. So that everyone that has one sort of was involved in that. So, anyway, where are we? 3:25 with you guys? Is that where we are? 3:25. Okay. 3:25. Do it! 3:30. Who is that? Over there, 3:30. Thank you. 3:30! Later than that. Actually, it's almost 3:30. So we'll stay at 3:30 until I hear 3:50. 3:50. You have 3:50. Tell you what, we'll take a Polaroid of David. I think this is fair, don't you think? To size, or proportionate, we will cut it out, or we will put it on there. And I think that's the most important thing. We need to get some things there that didn't get complete a couple years ago. I'm sorry. I had an argument about it. I remember that was also one of the things that, like, refrigerators were turned over and stuff. So, all right. Erase that contain, please. $400 with Mr. Greenlee's added, one of a kind, it will be the only one that has mouse on it. $400. $400 is where I'm going. Whoever meets me there takes it home quickly. I will stop when I hear the number. 400. Mm-hmm. We're at 360 now, so if anyone thinks that's that big of a jump, let me know. $400 with David Greenlee. The only copy that will have David Greenlee on, autographed by everyone that I can get my hands on before I send it to you. 360 going once. 50 going twice. Idea, shout it out.
Shout it out. Sold.
There you go. By the way, if you want to visit, that will be residing in Ohio. Thank you. The home of Neil Armstrong, if I remember
correctly. In my classroom.
All right, wrong trip. Okay, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Can you do better than that? Definitely. 13. There's 13? Is that what you meant? 13. David, well, zip it. The What on Earth is Happening to Television science fiction channel, Welcome to the Edge poster. They are 13 of a kind. They're the only one that exists. Please let me finish. In this room at this time.
They're heavy, but they put them together.
And, yeah, I think actually one would have been appropriate to carry around, but I just know why he didn't work that much. Okay.